Hi, my name is George Zhang, and I am a member, one of the founders of AirCare. What we're doing is we are helping to prevent hospital readmissions. So for those of you without a healthcare background, let me explain what I mean first. A hospital readmission is when a patient leaves a hospital and comes back again within a certain period of time, say 30 days is a standard metric, for reasons similar to why they left. Let's say I left because of heart failure reasons, and I come back within 30 days also because of symptoms related to heart failure. It's a big problem because it has the potential to wipe out hospital profits. Now, we all know that hospitals have very thin profit margins. Medicare, which is a government insurance plan, basically is penalizing hospitals for high readmissions, as well as for quality related to readmissions. In addition, more and more private insurance companies are not paying for readmissions. But our vision at AirCare is to go beyond just readmissions. Long term, we see ourselves as using readmission as a financial way of orienting the company to approach telehealth long term. Telehealth, again, has the potential to actually change healthcare as we know it, because many of us, myself included, don't necessarily want to go see a clinician. Go ahead, make an appointment ahead of time, weeks ahead of time, and see a clinician every time you want to be seen for a medical problem. So part of the vision long term is being able to have an application that allows you to connect to a clinician at a time at your convenience instead. There are a lot of reasons that people come back into a hospital. Some of the academic reasons include education, adherence, and access. Education meaning I may not know what I need to do when I leave a hospital in order to prevent a readmission. If I do know what I need to do, I may forget to do it on, say, a daily or weekly basis. And last of all, if I'm not doing well, it's not always clear or apparent that I can actually get access to a clinician immediately or very, very quickly in order to prevent a readmission or emergency room visit. And the traditional approaches that hospitals have used to manage readmissions have been very manual. In-home visits are perhaps phone calls. A patient leaves and within 24 to 48 hours, I as a nurse or a clinician will call the patient, and then maybe call the patient on a weekly basis until I'm sure the patient won't come back within 30 days for a readmission. But what we propose to do is actually automate the process and personalize the process. So when the patient leaves a hospital, right then and there, have the patient work with a nurse to actually customize a list of things that they have to do on a daily basis into a checklist, let's say. Have that checklist delivered to patients either through tablets, which we've negotiated deals with to provide patients with free tablets in exchange for data services with some of the leading mobile companies in the US, or for patients for whom it's not appropriate to have a tablet, convert the checklist into a form such as an automated phone call. Deliver these checklists or touch points to patients every day over a period of time, say 30 days, when hospitals are most financially prone to getting hit by penalties as well as by lack of insurance reimbursement. And then for those patients that are in trouble, making sure they have access to clinicians as well as family members to address the three points we mentioned earlier of education, adherence, and access. So we recently went through the Warden Venture Initiation Program as well as the Dream of Health Program. We finished 1.0 of our product and then are basically launching 2.0 of our product, which I'll show you guys shortly. And we've also locked down big pilots with the Hospital of University of Pennsylvania and Pennsylvania Hospital. We've also done some usability testing with cardiologists from Penn Presbyterian as well. So the things that would be most helpful for us would be to we're growing the team as we're adding additional features like hardware integration to our application. So any developers, full stack developers, especially those familiar with JavaScript, Node, we're looking to bring on more folks, as well as business people with some healthcare background or experience. So let me show you the application itself. So this is right now what you guys see is the nurse dashboard of different patients that are coming in. So as you can see, it has, well, this is all dummy data, as you can see. It's basically patient information, their age, their sex, discharge date, and the list of their latest events. You can see a tracking period over a time period, this is 30 days, where each column here is a day and each row here is a question. And you can delve down deeper as a clinician to see and track exactly how your patients have done on a daily basis. Let's say there's an issue with the swollenness of the belly that's happened, which is important for managing patients with heart failure readmissions. And by doing this, you can see how patients have done on a daily basis over a period of time, say 30 days, to make sure that they've been maintaining their health and answering their questions. And for those that are not doing well, you can initiate calls, manual calls or automated calls from a computer, desktop phone, mobile phone, and you're able to also link the patient record in with the tablets that have an issue with them through a tablet tracking device that we've developed. And for those patients who are not doing well, you can also initiate video sessions directly into patients' homes. So that's AirCare, and we'd be happy to take questions now. So we just launched our pilots literally in the last week or so. A lot of academic studies that have looked at these methods of reducing readmissions have obtained readmission rates in the sort of 40 to 60 to 70% range. Yeah, one of the things that we want to do early on is make sure we create our business as a communication platform. So the actual customization of the questions for the patients are done at the hospital by the nurses. Yeah. That's definitely important. One of the things that we realized early on was we needed to have the ability to have patients' medical records as well as medication history. And we've done that through a more manual process now. But long term, obviously, the goal is to build in things like EHR integration. That's a very good point. I mean, part of it is just good sort of security. So we're building encryption in on both ends. We're doing things like letting clinicians be involved in the setting of ranges. Of like, you know, of setting the points at which patients are considered in a danger zone. So instead of taking on that liability ourselves, and part of it is just getting good insurance.
Yeah, repeat the question.
Oh, sure. So one of the questions is, how does that work with elderly patients, especially those that don't have caretakers? One of the things that first we've noticed from a lot of our usability tests is many elderly patients, at least from the ones that we've seen so far, a majority do have some kind of caretaker. For those that don't, you're right, it can be hard to use technology, but that's where like user design comes in. For example, doing things like making the fonts very, very big for each question, having them take up a full page instead of a list of questions, locking the tablet so that the only application that's available is our application, as well as when they finish our application, having things like games or other videos be a reward for finishing application come in. Yeah, so the question was around, again, elderly patients, around notifications, as well as, I guess, around security. Let me try to tackle them one by one. No, I understand. For notifications, yes, we would have notifications go out to, say, caretakers who are taking care of their patients or taking care of their family members or patients who aren't doing well. There is an agreement you have to sign for that to happen, so it can't just be done without that agreement in place. And then for patients who don't, say, fill out the checklist on a daily basis because of issues with using technology, we actually can track that, because then you can sort of see questions haven't been filled in. And that actually creates a trigger that triggers a follow-up. And then security, again, I think it goes back to good sort of security practices and making sure that there's encryption in place, that when applications like this launch, that only people who have access to these records are the clinicians as well as the patients, things like that, and then insurance as well. Yeah, that's a great question. The way I think about it is that this is sort of like a program way of thinking about startups, which is that they're big markets, but in order to penetrate big markets, you sometimes have to go for a very deep pain point. So the hospital profitability chart I put up earlier is such a deep pain point that it's a market that startups can use to penetrate, establish a foothold, and create a product. And after that's done, using that product to go after other markets. But longer term, I totally agree with you. I think that's where the biggest opportunities are. Yeah, in terms of connectivity, right now we're using 4G data connections. If the connections aren't available, like let's say that they're in an area where they currently aren't able to get good 4G connection, they can use Wi-Fi. But if if they don't have access to one of those internet connections, it will show up as a missed day. So, I mean, there will be follow-ups for missed days, but you're right, like, if they don't have access to good internet connections, that can be a problem.
All right. Last question. How can the Philly tech community help you?
Sure. One is people. Again, we're looking for full-stack developers, especially JavaScript Node guys. Second is, you know, folks with healthcare and business backgrounds, as well as connections to hospitals, ACOs that can potentially use a product. We'd love to meet you guys.
All right, give him a hand.